momentarily, this aircraft was one of the world's first military jets to feature an afterburner. And we'll see that demonstrated in great fashion as he is cleared for takeoff.
The early MiG-17 did not have that.
Or the later ones.
What?
The later ones.
Yeah.
Jason Solms is from Camarillo, California, flying this quintessential enemy fighter of the 1960s and 70s, the MiG-17. We're going to see a display of remarkable high-speed flight, just under, at times, the speed of sound. He'll be coming by in a couple of passes in excess of 600 miles an hour. You can hear that afterburner going now as he's cleared for takeoff and sets up for his air start. Thanks to the efforts of Operations Have Drill and Have Donut, the MiG-17 supported our knowledge to fight against Eastern fighters, also known, well, as bandits, and to American fighter pilots, and our air-to-air kill ratio increased from 1 to 1 to 14 to 1. Inbound now, at the speed of heat from behind, please welcome Jason Solms and the Soviet MiG-17F Fresco. During the Vietnam War, it was the MiG-17 that was the primary enemy aircraft engaged by U.S. and Allied aircraft, including that of the A-4 Skyhawk, the A-7 Corsair II, the F-100 Super Sabre, and its primary nemesis, the F-4 Phantom II, just to name a few. As one of the world's first jet fighters to feature an afterburner, this new technology gave the MiG-17 incredible acceleration, especially against non-afterburning aircraft. Up until the introduction of the General Dynamics, now locked. That orange flame coming out the back made possible by its Klimov VK-1F engine. The operation of a jet engine is fairly simple. There's an intake on the nose and a fan that sucks that air in. There are smaller blades that compress the air where it's fed into a combustion chamber with an igniter and fuel. And that controlled explosion is what turns yet another set of fan blades, accelerating even more. That expelled air creates the thrust. In that final stage, raw jet fuel is added, giving the Fresco a significant kick in the rear. Demonstrating for us an aileron roll at show center, Jason Solms in the MiG-17F Fresco. It was this aircraft and its predecessor that was in the skies above Southeast Asia. Additionally, the Fresco could carry a variety of rockets, bombs, and even K-5 air-to-air missiles. We're going to watch Jason Solms now as he rolls the aircraft into the four-point hesitation roll. Two to the inverted, three to opposite knife edge flight, and four back to upright flight. How big about a round of applause for Jason Solms' four-point roll. Polish Air Force, one of just a few handful of MiG-17s flying in North America today. Jason is an accomplished aviator, type-rated in 17 different aircraft, taking his first flight lesson when he was just 12 years old. He's an avid racer at the National Championship Airways. He's a longtime member of the Commitment of Air Force's SoCal Wing. Continuing to climb into the vertical, giving us another great look at this cherry red MiG-17, the iconic bandit of the Vietnam War. Like takeoffs and landings were that angled wing design between the airspace. Well, at the final collapse of the Soviet Union, many nations began to liquidate anything they could, including a variety of ex-military equipment. Many of these MiGs became available on the civilian market and today serve as very popular jet warbirds. Simply put, it showcases our freedoms that we have to fly these airplanes in the United States of America.
Went down at the start of that pass.
Stand Eastern aircraft tactics and maneuvers. You can keep up with Jason on Instagram and YouTube at High Alpha Air Show. From the left, in the lead, the Soviet MiG-17. And on the wing, the ace maker, the T-33 shooting star. Be identified as an ace meant that of a tally of five or more aerial victories, the T-33 helping to create and train more aces than any other aircraft in history. Max speed of the T-33, 505 knots, 0.80 Mach, or 80% the speed of sound. It's a straight-winged subsonic aircraft and was a turn in the tide of technology as piston-driven. Inbound to start this full demonstration of the T-33 shooting star, from the right, the ace maker. It was on June 23rd, 1943. 105 shop men worked 10 hours a day, 6 days a week to build the very first XP-80, and in just 203 days it lifted off the dry lake bed in Southern California, flying for the first time with a top speed of 502 miles an hour. Scratch looks up at us from the inverted position now as he pulls back through this giant clover loop maneuver. Rob flies his show today to remember the heroes and to all of those veterans of the United States and Canadian militaries. Coming back down now from the left, airspeed about 400 miles an hour as he extends off to the right for the vertical Cuban ace. It was the Cuban 8 maneuver that was invented much by accident. So instead of making an unpleasant handshake with the ground, he decided to perform a 5/8 loop and roll upright, just as Scratch has. doing so twice and striping this big, giant, figure eight leg on its side. At the time, Lynn Povey was training the Cuban Air Force pilots, and they were amazed. They had never seen the maneuver before. They asked him what it was called. With quick wit, he replied, Ocho Cubano, or Cuban 8, and the name has stuck for over 80 years. How about a big round of applause for Rob Scratch Mitchell and his rendition of the classic Cuban 8? MiG-15s. He tracked over the tail of one of those MiGs, poured out a shower of 50 caliber machine gun fire, scoring the very first jet air-to-air kill, the first of 827 MiGs to be shot down in the Korean conflict. The P-80 serving between 1950 and 1953 got huge in technology. And of course, clocking in with speeds over 500 miles an hour, here's the high-speed pass. To this day, the T-33 remains the inbound now from the left. Here's the ace maker and the slow roll. A number of privately owned T-33s are available on the civilian market, and in fact, two were recently retired by the Boeing company, previously serving as chase aircraft. It was the T-33, just like this one, that safety chased the maiden flight of the Boeing 787 Dreamliner. Scratch, one of just a few pilots as part of Ace Maker Air Shows that fly at various events throughout the world each and every year. These T-33s, as I mentioned, stay very busy flying in air shows across North America and supporting our U.S. military. At Show Center, showcasing the tight turning capability of the Lockheed T-33. Technologies, Concorde batteries. First up, the lead aircraft in the formation is our venerable KC-10A extender. Known as the sledgehammer of air refueling, the KC-10 is the fastest and most capable tanker in the Air Force's patrol. It carries an astonishing 52,000 gallons of jet fuel up to blazes to 8.8 miles a minute. Cargo delivering fuel to the point of need. Now up front, there'll be two pilots and a flight engineer.